Hey man, this question is gonna be tricky, but I know so a lot of people like they want to hear what you have to say on this. So on your expertise, right? On your opinion, what will happen to the real estate market? What will happen to the stock market if Trump wins or if Biden wins?
Yeah, so it's a great question. That's a $1 million question, right? So I think a few things. One thing I've been talking about a lot on television in the last few weeks is that the stock market, first of all, is forward-looking. So they're trying to price in what they believe is going to happen well before it actually happens. And at the time that it happens, usually that's all been priced in, either the downside or upside. So let's first talk about the presidency. So, Trump or Biden, right now the polls are showing that Biden's going to win. Doesn't necessarily mean he's going to. It's also showing that Clinton was going to win prior to Trump winning 4 years ago. But if you don't think that the market is anticipating that Biden wins, like you're mistaken, because the odds are he will win. So the market's already started to price that in a little bit. And so if that happens, I don't see the stock market doing much. Obviously, you can get a 5 to 10% sell-off. That happens. A 10% sell-off in the market happens on average every 12 months. So just because you see the market pull back, that's just normal volatility. Remember, Jamar, stocks are liquid. Real estate, you can't just hit a button and sell it all and liquidate it in 24 hours. Stocks, you can. It's because of that liquidity that you have a lot more volatility in the stock market. The thing I'm more concerned about, what we're looking at for our clients, is really what happens between the House and Senate. Now, if you have the Democrats take over both the House and the Senate, and you have the presidency run by a Democrat being Biden in this case, then it's tough because there's no checks and balances. And so when you look at things like regulation, you look at things like taxes, those are usually not favorable to people with wealth. They're usually not favorable to business owners. So I think looking at that, and there's some key states like Iowa, Texas, Arizona that you want to see, keep an eye on there. If you get a red sweep, that's probably the bigger issue. And I think the stock market would not deal with that nearly as well. Real estate, let's remember, real estate's based off really two things long run. Number one, it's abilities people to be employed and be able to pay a mortgage. Obviously. Number two, it's largely impacted by interest rates. So let's talk about interest rates because I think that's the easier one. Well, the Federal Reserve is the one who sets short-term interest rates, which dictate everything else. The Federal Reserve has already come out and said publicly that they don't plan to raise interest rates until 2023. They've never telegraphed that far ahead in advance before. So, in terms of interest rates, that's on your side as a real estate investor. In terms of jobs, that's going to remain to be seen. Now, taxes are more than likely going to go up under Biden. They were at 35% prior to Trump, went down to 21. They won't go back to 35, but probably 28 on corporations. That could slow things down. The big question is what offsets that? Do you see things like infrastructure spending that creates some new jobs out of the Democrats that maybe can offset that? The other big thing is, especially in high income tax states like New York, California, there's something called the SALT limit, so state and local tax deduction. And so what happened is with Trump, it used to be whatever. If you paid $100,000 in state taxes, you could write that off. If you got $200,000 in property taxes, you can write that off. Now there's a $10,000 cap. And so that actually made it less beneficial to buy real estate, especially in states like California. Because if you make $175,000 as a couple in California, which is unfortunately barely getting by, that limits your further deduction. So any property taxes that you're paying are now non-deductible. So there's some talks about that actually rolling back if Biden comes in. And that actually could be favorable, contrary to popular belief, for real estate. So something like the something you want to listen to, what happens with that SALT cap? Does that go away? And if interest rates stay low, that creates a pretty good environment for real estate. Last thing I'll add is everything that we're doing in terms of printing money, sending checks out to people, all these different things, long term economically is very inflationary. You'll start to see inflation become an issue. And how do you counter inflation? A great hedge long term for inflation has been real estate, because real estate holds its value. So quite honestly, I think in some areas you might see a little bit of some frothiness in real estate, but the underpinnings of the market really are relatively healthy. I said last thing, but the other thing I'll say, there's still a very large supply-demand imbalance. So there's a lot more people wanting to buy homes than there are homes for sale. So really, at least for the next 12 months, which is almost like a decade now, when you try to predict out that far, it looks pretty good in my view.
Well, okay, man, that's great information. I know a lot of people be looking forward to hear this.